The first women's semi-final at the Montreal Grand Prix was between China's world number 7, Shao Yaqi, and Ukraine's world number 1 superstar, Olga Kharlan. Shao is one of the very few fencers in the world who has a superior head-to-head against Kharlan, leading 2-1. Kharlan was the form fencer of the day, though. We join the match at the start with Great Britain's head sabre coach John Southfield and Karim Bashir in the commentary box.
Straight off the mark. Well, again, we saw this in the Lembach Baird Air fight. Lembach calling for a video review on the very first action, and Shao has called for it as well. This time, though, it was the right call.
It was. I think it was a good call by Shao, overturned by the referee, changed his decision correctly into attack on preparation.
Fencers get 2 appeals in a match up to 15. If their appeal is upheld, they keep it. If the referee disagrees with them, they lose it. It's a bit like tennis in that respect. Just too good.
And then takes the reprise, mal parried by the Chinese fencer.
I'm going to give you a simple question. We talked about Olga Kharlan for a few years now. You've been joining me in the commentary box. She does something that I think perhaps people that don't fully understand fencing would need a bit of a better explanation of. And the way I'm going to put it is, it looks like Kharlan buys herself more time. She does something that allows her more time. What is it? What is it that she does?
All the great fencers seem to have more time than other people. Silagi does a similar thing. And back in my old days, Pozniakov, same thing. You just think, how does he have that much time to see what's happening and select an action and execute it? And it's partly down to the control of distance and timing. So the footwork preparation is vital for that, choosing the right preparation at the right time. But also it's about waiting until that very last moment for the correct moment to make the decision. Not thinking, oh, I need to get my light on quickly or the other person will hit me. You know, having that confidence to wait for the perfect moment to make the decision.
Yeah. Feet, so crucial. And, if you want to learn how to fence, the first thing you've got to get right is the feet, because you can have everything in the hand. You could even make the right decisions, but if you don't put yourself in the right place at the right time, you're never going to hit your opponent.
Shao turned things around and put herself in the right place at the right time to draw level.
Second intention, para riposte. It took 2 goes to get it, but she did in the end.
Wonderful hit. Kharlan took the attack really well. Shao saw it early, took a nice parry riposte, but Kharlan with the counter parry. So parry, counter parry, riposte.
At the start of the second period, Shao quickly restored parity.
Lovely compound attack by Kharlan. Shao started strongly in the second half. Took the game to Kharlan in the middle for the first couple of hits. Feinted one way, hit to the other side.
And you can see the acceleration as well on the slow motion. This is a bit more of a, not, it's not a simple attack, but it's a little bit more direct.
I think the key there was the way she developed the preparation at the beginning, very small and fast. Shao reacted by going back.
Despite Kharlan opening up a lead for the third time in the match, Shao came back again. It was inevitable that this one was going right down to the wire.
Second half, will she be able to keep her nerve?
Pressure on for the world number 1, Olga Kharlan.
Tap right for me.
The referee has to go and look at the video, though, and, well, John Southfield's called it for the right for Olga Kharlan right there. And the referee is just double-checking. Vikrat Valiev talking to Marius Florea. And a hit is given. Olga Kharlan made that a little bit more tricky than perhaps she needed to, but she is through to the gold medal match here in Montreal.
So a tough one for Kharlan, but she made it to the final. Our next semi-final saw Russia's Olga Nikitina, who had never won a Grand Prix medal, up against French fencer Charlotte Lembach, who won the Moscow Grand Prix in 2017. We join the match with Nikitina leading 3-2.
It's an interesting start here. Lembach looked for a couple of parries, but she hasn't been quite able to block out Nikitina, forcing the blade around. Good controller there. Again, you see she looked for a counter-attack and block. Nikitina's finishing in the low line quite a lot. And Lembach trying to block out in the second. This is parry 2 position. But Nikitina's just timing the attack really nicely. Attack right. Attack in preparation by the Russian. Poor pulls the French fencer short. Nice control of distance, and again finishes underneath the arm. You can see that same finish on the long attack. She tends to finish more chest in the middle and the flank on the long attack. Just hasn't quite got the timing for it at the moment.
Okay, I'm a foilist. That looked like a foil hit to me from Nikitina. Why has El Bakri given this to the left?
He's saying there was two actions that she missed with the first action. It wasn't continuous. They're looking at the video. My feeling was it was one action. Lembach had looked for the parapost.
Same for me, but that's because I'm a foilist. Medha Albakri is a Sabre referee, but he has changed his mind. It was a lovely little foil hit there, faint disengage.
Absolutely, yeah. Hit with a point. Just need a high cease flick to back to complete your day, Kerry.
I tell you what, someone needs a flick to the back, and that is Charlotte Lembach. She's 8-2 down.
A commanding lead for the Russian, and one that was unsurmountable.
Tap left this time, yeah.
A little bit more simple from Lembach.
It was almost casual, almost like I'm giving up, I'm just going to do a step lunge, and then she got the time.
It worked. Yeah, too casual from Lembach this time. She shakes the hand or high fives her opponent, who was just much better than her in that semi-final.
Nikitina joined Kharlan in the women's final. Join us next time as we take a look back at the men's semis.